Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Coldborough Park Farm, where I have a frog in my throat instantly. Oh, dear. We are in the Massey 7718, and we have a trailer load of bales. We've got 15 bales on the trailer at the moment. Yeah, it's not entirely full, but it's all straw. And if you're in the stream, you'll know that I was saying I was going to screw with the money. Out of character, I said I was going to screw with the money out during the stream. I've changed my mind. I'm going to keep the 14k. And so yeah, we got a Marshall 36-foot trailer, which means we can fit four bales on either side. I'm pretty sure this thing can fit three bales high. I'm only ever going to go to two. It's going to be loaded and unloaded manually. And this is the bullet bill one. I know. I said I'd never use it. I was trying to use the Marshall Giants locking script, and one of the bales decided to start hovering, and it started kicking the other bales off the trailer. So I've gone for the autoloader. I will only ever be using this manually, though. I won't be using the autoload functions. I've just noticed the fan is working in the Massey. The engine fan actually works. Can you open up the... Oh, you can open the bonnet. Yeah, you can see the radiator fan in there actually moving. That's a really nice bit of detail that I never knew was a thing. So let's hop in. And we'll dump these into the sell point. Now, I have done quite a lot of work off camera. I've upped a number of streams, if you haven't noticed. This is going to be out of character for a while. I've upped a number of streams to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from 1. So you're getting 10 hours a week of this instead of, as it was, 4. Just because I don't want to do the mapping on stream anymore. If I make major progress with the map, I will do a video. Okay, so one thing I do need to do is move this. So I think that's about all the out of character stuff that I want to talk about for now, at least. If I think of anything else, I will jump. Now, plans for the video, because I do have plans. Oh, do I have plans? I have plans upon plans upon plans. Plan number one is to set off the trailer load of bales. If you hadn't already guessed. I'm wondering, is it actually better for me to... Plan number two is... There's been some construction work going on at Yatton Ridge. And I have got word from the builders that they have finished today. And they finished all their clearing up work. So we can go to Yatton Ridge and have a look at what we have got in. Why I haven't shown Yatton Ridge in any of the videos. I know I showed it in the stream, but I wasn't actually planning on doing building work back then. So yeah, they finished the building work over in Yatton Ridge, and okay. This fully backwards, thank you. Let's take the straps off the bales. I don't think the loading area is... Is the back of the trailer actually hitting off the bales at the back here? Yes, it is. Right. So let's do something that I wasn't originally planning on doing. And let's F15. Toggle unloaded side is M, so we want to unload the back. Hit O to set those bales. Then I want to. It doesn't matter. Oh, good. We'll just reverse this trailer in here because I know I'm out of cab to deal with it. Because I'm going to disconnect that. And we are going to be swapping out some equipment. The first thing we're going to be... Well, we're going to be moving it at the very... Well, we're swapping it out. I've kind of given an accidental spoiler. First thing we're going to do is get rid of this cultivator. It's a bit too big for my needs. It's just too big. So... And I know people are going to complain when they see what the plan is. So this is going to go. And before we actually hit the sell button, before we pull the trigger, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the second piece of equipment that's going bye-bye. Because it is also a bit too big for my needs. So I'm going to turn on the beacons here. I'm going to turn left out of here just because it's a bit easier. If you're wondering, the funky flashing light is the beacons. It's kind of an indicator for you guys to show that the beacons are in fact on. It serves basically no other purpose. So down to the shop we go. Gonna talk real quick. We finished all the baling. That's all done and dusted. What I have done is I've got all the hay sorted out up over at Chantry at Yatton Ridge. I have done some construction work over at Chantry as well. I've done some moving of things, hopefully. That hasn't broken. Hopefully many things haven't broken, because I did change some of the stuff in the scene graph. Gonna really quickly have a look at this. Just while I'm driving. Whoops. Okay, so that's going through the stuff loading in. It's drive control. So I'm at... Still soil mod. Because if there's an error, it will be up here when I am loading in the map. Oh, buggeration, I've broken. Bugger. I have somehow broken pigs and beef. Yeah, that's a bug fix that'll need to be done. People who have the map, because I have given some people the map, check that, I'll actually send them messages and get them to check. Because I may need to send them the bug fixes. Because I have sent some people this edit and not realized that there may have been bugs. So yeah, currently there's no using pigs or beef on the map. And I'm going to have to let people know that. Bugger. That should be a relatively easy fix to do. I think it's just decided that it's not gonna register fill types for some reason. That's irritating. Just gonna blast my way up to Coldborough again, because otherwise you'll end up with a half hour video of me selling these two things. I'm kind of angry now, because that was a really silly thing for me to do. In theory, I should be able to fix it, though. And in theory, it's going to take me about half an hour. Or two an hour to fix. Good. Can you tell I didn't test this map before I loaded it in? Because I did edit it tonight. I didn't think that it would cause problems. So I need to find the... I'll have to load up the log file after this as well. Oh, this is going to be painful. So I'm going to bring in a little tour real quick before I get the second piece of equipment. The second piece of equipment is going to be the seeder. 5 and 6 meters. I think that the cultivator I'm selling off is 5 meters. That's a bit too big. What I'm doing is I'm swapping to 2 3-meter pieces of equipment. I have a Kuhn Cetera 3000. That really nice cedar, brand new, and I've been assured that it works properly. What have I done down here? Oh yes, down here, you may remember, if I brought you down here at all, that the edit didn't save. That's mildly concerning. That may explain why pigs and beef are broken. And if the edit didn't save, I'm kind of abandoning the video now, because legit problems. This isn't going to be cut out, this is me problem solving now. If that didn't save, presumably either I didn't do it, which I find a bit hard to... Oh, maybe I didn't, because the first time it... May not have done that edit. And if I didn't... Obviously I'm out of character at the moment. If I didn't do that edit, I'll do it real quick before the stream on... Well, tomorrow. Yeah, it's still Tuesday for me, so... Sorry if I get confused with days. I'll fix that before the stream tomorrow. I'll actually fix it probably yesterday. Hooray for time continuity and stuff. Now I want to go and check Yatton Ridge Farm, because I did do an edit down here as well, and if it's the... can I see what I've done down here? It's a bit misty yet. This is not ideal. So I did down here, should be off to the left here, and... Okay, so this edit did survive, so something I've done over here is broken pigs and beef. Or something that was already existing. They flicker through each other because I put them way too close. I've moved the one shed away from here, put 2 sheds in its place, and... The seeds and fertilizer that were in there are now over here, all lovely and kind of tucked out of the way. That last seed pad looks like it's floating, because it is. It's another minor fix I need to do. But yeah, the bales are going to go into those 2 sheds. One's going to be for hay, one's going to be for straw. They are, by for all intents and purposes, identical, so it's just going to be a case of deciding which shed is for which. Pigs and beef I'm going to need to fix, apparently. Looks like the lure's broken for some reason. But yeah, I just need to edit a small part of the map then. That's actually fine. So, going back on topic. Because I have kind of reassured myself that the edits I did do were saved. I'd kind of forgotten that the giant zitter crashed halfway through. So going back on topic and into character, so that's the construction work we had done. It wasn't particularly long work. I mean, they just pretty much demolished the old pole shed that was there. There was nothing particularly wrong with it, I just didn't like it. It was getting old, so that's been demolished. been replaced by two newer sheds, which look older, but they're newer, I promise you. And, yeah, that's kind of what happened over there. Chantry, I meant to move a few things around, apparently I forgot to. I'll be doing that fairly sharpish, because I don't like the fertilizer being right beside the fuel. That's an explosion hazard. It's an explosion waiting to happen, in fact. So, did I miss a bale? No. Okay. So yeah, the second piece of equipment we are going to get rid of today, and we are going to set it off today to buy more reasonably sized equipment, because this... The large equipment that we have currently is from when we were doing a lot of contracting work. I mean, we used to do contracting, and the 6 meter stuff just kind of fit the contracting a bit better than stuff we would normally use, so that's the reason we have such large equipment currently. So what I'm gonna do is, there's the baler, by the way, that needs to be washed. Because this hasn't been used in a while, it's still clean from the last time we washed it. I'm just gonna bring this straight down to the shop, and we're gonna set it straight off. Now, I do have an order placed, and once these guys are gone, I'll be able to just walk in, tell them exactly what I've ordered, and then I'll pay in cash straight, you know, right there and then. That case works like a charm. There's absolutely no issues with it. Very comfortable. Very easy to get used to. Mainly because it's almost identical to the New Holland. It's just got a less powerful engine. It's turning right out here this time. Don't care if anything's coming from the left. They should see the big tractor coming across the road and expect me to not stop. And we're just gonna head straight down to the shop. I'm not gonna cut the video here. There's no real point in it. Mainly because I got so much work to do tonight to try and figure out what's wrong with pig's beef and chantry. That's gonna be fun, and I'm gonna have to tell everybody who currently has the map that they might need to start a new save game. Or they're gonna have to dump that edit in favour of some, because I need to fix that. That's a pretty big problem. I think one person might be able to fix it themselves. That's going to be a problem solving exercise for them, because they're planning on going into mapping. You know who you are if... why is that gate open? Oh, I didn't break the gate script as well, did I? I swear, if I've broken anything else, I'll be extremely annoyed. Let's just throw the beacons on so people know we mean business. And I am gradually getting more and more concerned by the amount of stuff that just doesn't look right. No gate there. I'll have to find somewhere that has a gate that opens and shuts, and I think the gate script is broken as well. Oh boy, I'll have to be looking through the log file with a fine-tooth comb tonight. So if you watched the stream today and you wondered why I was a bit angry, it's probably because I've been spending half the night looking through a log file, desperately trying to figure out what I've broken. Oh, I gotta lower it. No enough. So let's sell these. 11.4 for top down 500. There we go, lovely. And over here we want the Cuckerling Trio, which almost all the tractors can run. And we also want the Kuhn Zotero 3000. I could go for the Rapide 300. I don't see any reason why. Well, this is going to be a bit easier to maneuver than a big long trail thing. This is just going to go straight onto the 3-point. Most of the tractors can run that lovely. So let's do something incredibly stupid and hook both of these on at once. I'm going to put the seeder on the front and the cultivator on the back, because I think getting hit by the seeder is probably a better idea for drivers. They'd prefer to be hit by something blunt rather than something with a lot of sharp, spiky implements. Never mind, they're both as bad as each other. So if I hit anybody, they're dead. But this is the easiest way to get everything down. Short of... Actually, I might do that. Let's have a look at the... Duneske. Should have a couple of traders here. I swear I had more than just the two. Could get one of these guys. Is there one in... Not there... in here there might be a transport trailer, maybe? No. Okay, then let's get one of the Eager Beavers. We'll get the black one, because it's a bit more subdued. We'll have to lower down the cultivator again. Disconnect it, and just spin around. I know that I'm out of cab, deal with it. It's quicker this way. Okay, so that should be close enough to connect. Yep, good. And then I want to go X to lower the ramps. Probably disconnect the trailer again. And now, spin around to connect up the cultivator once again. This is a mess, but it's gonna work. Okay, raise the cultivator up. Lovely. And we're gonna back the cultivator on. Because this can't possibly go wrong. So there we go, the cultivator. And I'm kind of amazed that I made it up in one go. Down off the trailer we go. To grab the seeder, which should just about fit. This is a tight fit. We don't need the PTO or anything else, so it's literally just... Bang, there we go. That's all we need hooked up with the seeder right now. And again, we're going to reverse it on. Which doesn't terrify me in the slightest. Okay, that's the wheels on. Kind of. Mainly. Lower the seeder there, and that's gonna actually work. Except maybe I might have a bit of trouble actually, you know, transporting this, because I don't think the backboards are gonna be very accommodating. Let's find out what happens. I want to hit O and X. And hopefully this doesn't cause a million more problems. And, oh, it's folded in nice and neatly underneath. What happens when I start driving? No major problems, good. So let's definitely put the beacons on this time and head out. I'm going to be keeping a close eye on the mirrors because I don't want anything falling off. They're not strapped down particularly well. Not strapped down at all. But they should hold on with just their weight. Hopefully, in theory. They look pretty solid on there, so that's a definite bonus. And I'm not gonna go too fast. So I guess the video is gonna end when we go back up to the farm. Because there's not much time remaining, and then I'll have to run off and fix all of the things that are broken. Which is lovely. I think I know how to fix one or two of the problems, at least. So, with the pigs and beef, the issue, I believe, is that they're in the wrong order in the map XML. Or the A3D, one of the two. They're in the wrong order for the additional products, because the Seedmasters load after them, and they kind of need to load up their stuff as they go along. The gate, the potential issue with the gates, I'm going to test it on this one. I don't know. Never mind, the gates work. Just to check, yep, gates work. Good. Okay, so there's no problem with the gates. The issue's with the pigs and beef, and I think I know how to fix that in hopefully less than 5 minutes. Because I do want to do other stuff tonight, if possible. And I want to also fix the minor issue at Chantry Farm, where the fertilizer is too close to the fuel. So that's all the stuff that runs through my head. And again, I'm just kind of in this out of character because screw it. Fahy said in the stream today for me, yesterday's stream for you guys, he said using GE, because he's fairly new to GE, but the more he gets to know Giant's editor, the more problems he finds with maps. And that is just so true. If you start making maps for yourself, or start editing maps, or start working on maps at all, as I punch my microphone, as soon as you start working on maps, you start finding things you want to fix. And you start thinking of ways you could fix this or fix that. And sometimes you can't think of a way to fix it. Sometimes you're just thinking, huh, that needs fixing, I don't know how. And you kind of go off for a few months, and or for a few days or a few weeks, and you think about it, and you edit another map, and you kind of stumble upon the answer. That's how I know how to fix the pig and beef thing, if it is the issue that I think it is. I need to find the line that I need to fix, but that's what I believe it is. Stuff like, I have added fill from air to the combi liner here. The Cetera combi liner. Which means, in theory, I can do, if there is some available in the Seedmaster, which there should be, it wasn't the last thing I did in the stream today. Yes, there's seeds available. It means that in theory, this should fill it up. And this is my hope. Among hope. So I am out of cab, I know. This is just because I'm demonstrating something. And I want to try and get this good. In theory, this should now be filling the cedar, but it's not. Because I haven't set seeds to as a fill type. That's a 5-minute fix. Less. That's very easily fixed. Sometimes fixes are really complicated and require a lot of knowledge. Sometimes it's just, oh, I made a small goof. I have a 30-second fix, you know. People think that, oh, you know, editing mods and fixing mods is so difficult. It is if you don't know what you're doing. Look at the likes of Dave Oldfield and people like that who do edit mods regularly. And who do it and have a basic knowledge. They might not know everything, but they've got at least a basic working knowledge of how X, Y, and Z should work and how X, Y, and Z work in any given mod. And they can figure out how to fix it. It's the same principle. It's, well, I know this is a thing, and I know this is what its current state is. So if I do this, I can get it from where it is now to where I want it to be. Which is exactly what I'm doing with the cedar, although I did forget a line in the XML, which is my own stupid fault. Also, if Bullet Bill is watching, my god, your scene graph is a... And I guess it's your own organizational style, but to me it just looks like a mess. It just... There's things everywhere. It's not the organization style I'd use personally, but that's, yeah, my style versus your style. In any case, I'm gonna leave the video here. Thank you all very much for watching. I've been Rained with Dave. Actually, in the next video, we should in theory be selling off the crops. That's gonna be starting on streams. Once I got the bales sorted out, the crop sales will start. If we're not selling crops, we'll be starting the cultivating. And, we'll be doing the cultivating. That's the plan that we'll do. Yes. So the plan is we're going to sell the bales off first, get rid of all the bales out of the fields. Then we are going to start with the cultivating. And we're going to use the stubble cultivator, which, just ignore the fact that the cultivator I have wouldn't work as a stubble cultivator. And after that, we're going to lay down some lime onto the fields with this little guy. I love you guys too, promise. And I do hate myself that much. I'm going to lay down some lime, and then we're going to start seeding. And working on soil conditions so they're correct for as close to optimal growth as I can get. So there's our kind of longer term plan. The baler is sticking around. Actually, both balers are. I did reset this one so I could change the sheds up at Yatton Ridge. Balers are both sticking around. The quadrant was intentionally bought as something for the future. Also, I'm going to edit these bales away. These bales are nice, but they kind of get in the way, so I'm going to shove them all under the map somewhere and they can fall into oblivion. So thank you all very much for watching. Until next time, stay safe, and goodbye.